jumping out of whip shit cold. Watching my step ground froze. Most my day spent alone. Same with my bro, he knows. Gotta pay dues. Walking in mud, you could check my.
Hey y'all, what's up? Welcome back to another video. Welcome to the channel. So we're doing a work vlog today, and I wanted to answer a question that I don't think I have mentioned anything about on this channel. And it has to do with where you can actually work. Now, coincidentally, I actually just pulled up Google, searching for something random, dealing with Arise, and I came across this ad that said you can virtually work anywhere remotely in the U.S. And that is false advertisement, you guys. There are a couple of states that you are not able to work on the platform, so I'm just going to give you those states because there's not that many. But I noticed a lot of people... In my personal experience this year, in 2022, I have had a lot of people come and try to register to work with my call center, but they didn't live in the state that was applicable. So, if California, if you live in California, it's a no-go. Connecticut, District of Columbia, Maryland, Massachusetts, New York, Oregon, and Wisconsin. Why Arise does not work with these particular states, I have no idea, but it's not the first time that I've seen this. When I did MLM companies, I've noticed that a lot of MLM companies, you couldn't register if you lived in these particular states as well. So I don't know what it is about these 8 states, but for some reason, if you are wanting to work on the platform, you won't be able to if you are servicing from one of these states. Now, I have had somebody ask me if they were moving to a different state, would they be able to register their profile under that state? Now, I don't want to say yes and no to that, because when you register to the platform, it is going to ask you some personal information, address, stuff like that. So I don't know how that's necessarily going to work, as far as you currently living in the state but is moving to another state and you want to go ahead and get started until you move to another state. Like, I don't know how that's going to work, because you've got the background check, and then you've got, you know, there's just so many different components where it may not work. So I don't know if that'll work or not. I've never tried it. I've never had anybody partner with my call center that tried to do that that I know of. So I'm not sure, y'all. But anyway, the clock is ticking. I'm already a few moments late because I had some computer issues. Windows update and all that jazz. So let's go ahead and get into a call. Sure, I can request embark and disembark assistance for you. That way they can provide a wheelchair and onboard there. What's your booking number? Okay, thank you. What's your date of birth and who's going to be traveling with you? Awesome. It looks like you and us are married, so welcome. And you're going to be cruising soon on the December 21st. Just a moment and I'll go ahead and request assistance for you. And they will be waiting for you at when you get to the pier to assist you aboard. So. Yeah, I'm sure you can. Awesome. So it will allow you to use a wheelchair so that you don't have to stand while you're waiting there. And let's see, another thing you can also do is see if we still offer early embarkation, early boarding. Let's see. Okay. Did you need to book any transfers for your cruise today? Transfers from the airport if you're flying in. Are you guys flying in or driving? Done at the ship once you get to the pier, but when you speak with the crew members, just let them know that if it's possible that you'd like to embark a little bit earlier, let's see, that way you don't have to wait as long in line. And I'm pretty sure they'll be happy. That way you don't have to wait that long in line. They'll be more than happy to accommodate you. They'll actually approach you as you're coming towards the pier. One of the crew members will approach you. That way you'll have the opportunity. They may ask you to, if you need assistance with any luggage or anything like that. So someone will walk up to you to guide you to the right area. And that's a good opportunity to let, to ask them about the early embarkation process. So. If you have any more questions for me, you're welcome. Refrigerator, as well as a safe, a hair dryer, phone, TV. There isn't a coffee maker, you're right about that, but there is a refrigerator in there. There is, yes ma'am. And if you need more, you just request it from the staff if you need more shampoo or soap. So. You're welcome. You enjoy your cruise. Awesome. You enjoy your cruise. Thank you, too. And thank you for calling. In case of any emergencies, we know what the nearest home airport is for you. Speak with an agent. She told me a sale date that you were looking at, March 4th of 2023, correct? For a Panama Canal sailing. Okay, and she said you had a cabin in mind, cabin 1002, is that correct? Okay, and she also provided me her mariner number, so I can put that in. And she said there's three guests traveling, is that also correct? Okay. Thank you, Mr. Jasper. And I've got your mariner number. Are the other two guests traveling, Sylvia and Donna? Okay. At the 14-day Panama Canal. Is that correct? The Sun Fair? Oh, let's see, because we don't have a ship by that name. Okay. Right. Panama Canal, 14-day coming back to San Diego. No? Okay. Ship by the sunshine or the sunrise. However, that might be right. Okay. Okay, so it's a 10-day. So give me just a second. Let me see if I can locate that particular sailing. So it goes both places. So it's a technically like a Caribbean itinerary, but it also goes to Aruba and Panama Canal. Okay. And were you looking? Right. Yes, sir. I did. No worries. So we are on the same page now. So oh, I'm sorry. Say that one more time. You broke up a little bit. Oh, sure. So you get the best of both places here, the Caribbean and Aruba. Okay, so now that we're... Oh, did you? How did you enjoy it?